And then from there on, we just kind of developed a relationship, and here we are. We've been married for, over 4 years now. And they've been the best 4 years of my life. Well, there's 8 years of my life. But that's been a big blast. Play the trumpet primarily. I also play piano, also play the drums. But trumpet was my primary instrument. I've come a long line of trumpet players in my family. My grandfather was a professional jazz musician, professional jazz trumpeter. My father played as well, not professionally. My grandfather put a stop to that. So it's kind of been in the blood, the family, and did all the bands in high school and played my whole life. But kind of gotten away from it past several years. I'm looking to get back into it. It's one of those things, especially at a young age, when anything, but especially music, when it gets instilled into you, you never lose that. And it's a passion that will always be with me, and I'd like to get back to that.
Hi, I'm Dr. Laura Boone, interventional cardiologist with the Heart Care Group. Have you ever wondered what it would be like to walk through your heart and explore the inner workings of your heart? Well, we can do that today. Behind me, you see the Mega Heart. It's a huge, inflatable, walkable heart model so that we can explore the inner workings of the heart, talk about different diseases that affect our heart, and how we can prevent them. So come with me as we explore your heart. So where I'd like to begin our journey is in the right atrium. The right atrium is where all of the deoxygenated blood that has already been used by the body's vital organs comes into the heart so that it can get pumped to the lungs and get reoxygenated for your body to use. So come with me as we enter into the right atrium. This is the tricuspid valve. With every heartbeat, the tricuspid valve opens and closes and allows deoxygenated blood to come from the right atrium into the right ventricle. The right ventricle is a smaller but still very important pumping chamber of the heart. It pumps blood that's been deoxygenated, that's been used up, to the lungs so that it can be replenished with good, healthy oxygen. This is the pulmonic valve. This is where the deoxygenated blood exits to the lungs. So up to the lungs we go. So after we finish our journey through the lungs, healthy oxygenated blood comes back into the heart, into the left atrium, which is on the other side of the mitral valve. With every heartbeat, the mitral valve opens and closes and allows the healthy oxygenated blood to come into the left atrium, into the left ventricle. This is the heart's main pumping chamber. That's where we are standing right now. The left ventricle is exceedingly important. It's a strong, muscular pumping chamber that pumps healthy oxygenated blood out through the aortic valve into the rest of the body. And I'm going to walk through the aortic valve right now. This is the aortic valve that opens and closes with every heartbeat and pumps blood into the aorta, which is where I'm standing right now. The aorta is the body's most important blood vessel, and it connects the heart to all of the major vital organs and tissues, delivering healthy, oxygenated blood. Welcome to the outside of your heart. This is where the arteries of the heart, called the coronary arteries, feed the heart muscle itself with its own healthy, rich, oxygenated blood supply. These are the arteries of the heart here, what you see in red. This is where plaque can build up. This is the thing that we are most concerned about, particularly my specialty. When plaque forms within the arteries, you are at risk for a heart attack because not enough blood can get through and get to the heart's muscle. When that happens, then you can have a myocardial infarction, most commonly known as a heart attack. When there's not enough blood coming through this artery to the heart muscle, you get a big area of scar. That's dead tissue because there wasn't enough blood to feed it healthy, oxygenated blood. We treat a heart attack a lot of times with stents to try to keep the artery nice and big and open. Sometimes when we aren't able to stent an artery, we have to rely on bypass surgery. And bypasses look like this. This is a bypass graft. It comes off of the aorta and feeds very nice, healthy, oxygenated blood to the arteries of the heart, bypassing the plaque that has built up. This allows good blood to get fed through to the heart's muscle and keep it healthy and strong. Well, thanks for joining me as we take a journey through your heart using the Mega Heart. Cardiovascular disease is still the number one killer of Americans, so we all need to take steps to stay healthy and active and keep our hearts healthy. Thanks for joining me, and I hope it was a good journey for you.
Well, my dad was a doctor. And ever since I was a kid, it was kind of drummed into my head that I'm not going to be anything else but a doctor. So that's how I ended up in medicine. And I've grown to love the art of medicine. I chose neurology because when I was going to choose my specialty, it seemed that cardiology had gone a long way. You know, a lot of the medical specialties had made a lot of breakthroughs, and neurology at that time did not. And so I felt that there was a lot of potential for the specialty of neurology, and true enough, over time, a lot of discoveries have been made to improve patient care, a lot of new technology to diagnose diseases. So that was the main reason why I chose neurology, because it was an open frontier. I had two daughters. The oldest is 32, the youngest is 28. My wife, I think we've been married 32 years now. She works for the pair. Yeah, I met her when I was a freshman in college. Perfect weekend would be waking up late in the morning. You know, every day you go to work, you're up at 6 to get to work by 8. So, yeah, not having to worry about any deadlines, waking up late, and then having a good breakfast, and then go to martial arts class, and then come home, have a good lunch, go visit the granddaughter, and then
play with the granddaughter, and then, you know, go out with the wife and, you know, have a good dinner and then come home and relax. That would be a good weekend. I've been doing this particular style of karate is called Shotokan. I've been doing this for like 21 years. Martial arts are great, keeps you young, keeps you fit. There's always something new to learn, you know. There's when you learn a new technique or some, or your brain's always making new connections. So it'll keep your brain young, keep you young. Yeah. Of course, I was growing up during the time the Beatles were popular, and so I still like the Beatles. And a lot of the music from the 60s, because that's what my sisters played. My first car, I was in Manila then, I was in college. We bought the car from my brother-in-law. It's a Dutch car, and it's called a DAF. It's a D-A-F. It's a motorcycle engine that they put a car body on it. It only goes 2 gears forward and back. I think if a patient comes to see me, I think they can be assured that, you know, I will take the time to evaluate them. I'll certainly examine them thoroughly and address all their issues. I'm not going to rush them out of the office. So, and of course, try to solve the problems or the issues. And if I cannot solve them, send them to someone who can.
I'm Dr. Chris Menendez. I'm the medical director at the Best Health Center, Bedford Hospital. I've had a lot of questions this week about Angelina Jolie and the steps she took to practically